Hello and welcome to Azure Vala YouTube channel. We are in part 23 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 50 questions. We are going to look into question number 51 today. So let's move. Question number 51. You have an Azure subscription named Subscription 1. Subscription 1 contains the resource groups in the following table. We have one resource which is called resource group, which is called RG1, that is in Azure region West Europe, and it has policy 1. Next is RG2 resource group, which is in North Europe, and it has policy 2 implemented over it. Next region is resource group 3, which is in Azure region France Central, and it has policy 3 implemented. RG1 has web app named web app 1 inside it, and web app 1 is located in West Europe. So the location is set for web app 1 is West Europe, and the RG1 also you can see that West Europe is set. You move web app 1 to RG2. Now RG2 location is different, or the region is different. So the North Europe it is having. Now what is the effect of that move? So we are going to check the effect of that move. So let's first understand definitions. So first thing, resource group. Resource group in Azure is a new approach to group a collection of assets in logical groups for easy or even automatic provisioning, monitoring and access control, and for more effective management of their cost. So in short, it's a logical group of contain resources which we can club together and see their cost and rest of the parts together. Next concept is app service plan, that defines a set of computer resources for a web app to run. So it's we can consider a set of computer resources for web app to run is called app service plan. And when create an app service plan in a certain region, for example, West Europe is given here, a set of computer resources, so physical computer resources, is created for that plan in that region. So this is how it is done. And so wherever we create the app service plan, it's going to create or reserve or take the resources from that certain physical location. The next one is web apps. So Azure web apps provide a platform to build app in Azure without having to deploy, configure and maintain your own virtual machine. So just to, it's a way to avoid having virtual machine, we can have web app, so that web app can run the code on that. So I have created a diagram based on our question here, that we have resource group 1 in place and we have resource group 2 in place. These are containers basically, which is having resources in it. And resource group 1 is region is West Europe, resource group 2 region is North Europe, and definitely web application is inside RG1 before we move it. So that is also having West Europe region, and it is associated with the app service plan. So once we are moving this application, web application, to RG2, what's going to happen, or what is the impact on that, we are going to see this. And it is having different policy in place, and that is also in question. It was mentioned like policy 1 for this group, resource group, and policy 2 is for resource group 2. So just for understanding that if we move any application from one resource group to another resource group, it's not going to change its region. So region will remain same. So web application would remain in West Europe region, but it will run on the RG2 having the North Europe region. So region will remain same. But the second thing you can understand, this example, like if we are moving from one country to another country, So for example, this country to this country, if we are moving, so it has certain rules in place. We have to follow this, and the next country would have certain rule in place. So when we change location to location, it's going to impact. So the policies would be changed. So here the policies are P2. So for this web application, since this web application is residing inside this region or resource group 2, therefore it will have policy 2 in place, not the policy 1. While the application was running in resource group 1, it was having policy 1 in place. So I hope this is clear. Now back to the question. Now we will see the options. So let's start with the D. Option D is that app service plan for web remains in the West Europe. That is correct. So this part of this answer is correct. Policy 1 applies to web app 1. Since the policy 1 is applied in resource group 1, not in the resource group 2, so this part is wrong. Once we move the application to resource group 2, the policy will apply of the resource group 2. So this is wrong. Option C. The app service plan of web app 1 moves to North Europe. So it will not change the app service plan, and it would remain the same in West Europe. So that part is wrong here, and policy 1 applies, that is also wrong here. Option B, the app service plan for web app remains in West Europe. That is correct, it is not being touched, and it would remain in the same region. So that is correct. Policy 2 applies to web app. So since we have moved to resource group 2 and policy 2 is in place, so that policy would apply in web app 1. So this part is correct. Basically this option B is correct entirely, not one part. The app service plan for web app 1 moves to North Europe, that is also wrong. That's not going to move to North Europe, it's just going to change the resource group. And policy to apply, that part is correct, but half of this part is wrong. So option A is wrong. So finally, option B is our answer. And I hope I was able to clear the concept of this, but I will quickly show you in Azure portal as well. In Azure portal, I have created resource groups, which are RG1 and RG2 for understanding this. And RG1 and RG2, we kept different region. So RG1 is having East US and RG2 is having West US. So these are different region. And now what we created, what we have done is we have created the resource in RG1 or web app in RG1, and we moved it to RG2 just to see. And for that application also we kept the region East US. So let's see. Now if we go to RG1, there is app service plan is residing in it, because app we have moved, but app service plan is there. So when we created the app, we were having the location East US. So app service plan has the same East US location in place. Again, we go to RG2. We can see we have moved this application. Earlier it was in RG1. We have moved, but its location is East US. And for this resource group, if we see the resource group 2, its location is different than this. So resource group 2 has West US, while application is having East US as the location. That proves that when we move the application one region to another region, the location remains the same, and whatever regardless of resource group location, and same time the policies are implemented on resource group level. Therefore, the wherever the resource is being moved, it is going to have the new policy in place. I hope I was able to explain this question properly, and if you have liked the video, please like, subscribe, and press the bell notification icon. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching, and see you next video.